Hi. So, I guess I'm just gonna go back a bit. So, I was a furry before I was gay. There's not much, just like a very tiny, teeny, tiny gap. I've been interested in a lot of, like, I guess, anthropomorphic characters. That's usually like the stigma. Zootopia definitely got me, man. Oh, God. I'm still waiting for Zootopia 2, which is gonna come out next year? Or is it coming out this year? I can't remember. I remember hearing something about it, though. I'd say it was around maybe 8th to 9th grade, I feel like. Although, I feel like I was, like, looking up characters like that before and it, like, and sort of admiring them. And also, Gadget from Rescue Rangers was kinda hot at that point. I don't know why. I haven't even talked about how I picked my species either. Fuck. See, at the time, I was pretty sure that I was Irish, because I can do, like, a decently good Irish accent. I was like, yeah, let's stick with the whole Irish vibe. And I looked up, like, Irish dog species. But I found a Welsh, either red and white setter, or just called a Welsh setter. And I still have the guy to this day. And I have more art of him. I wish I had more art of, like, the 10 more, like, OCs that I have that have, like, no backstory. Even my own Sona has no backstory. Well, I guess it's the backstory has always been, like, it's me, but dog. This is gonna get into some, like, deep shit. You guys can know if you want to skip it or not, and then I'll just put, like, a marker for that as well, or whatever. So, oh yeah, I was in, I think it was Furry Agenda? It was a Discord that I was in a while ago that I'm not in anymore. I was talking to this person at that time, and they drew like fucking amazing art, mind you. Although I haven't seen much of them though, probably just because they're on Instagram and I'm not really on social media much anymore because it's icky. It drained me. I felt like shit. We started talking, and like instantly, I already liked them. I liked like the vibe that they gave off, and even though I was a bit immature on how I went around it, I'm gonna admit that I'm not really sure what I'd consider what we were. We were technically dating. I'm gonna put lots of air quotes for that, because again, I didn't, and still don't really understand how relationships work. We started showing each other art, and at that time, I was doing like art on my phone and shit, and it looked horrible. I still have the old shit. I'm gonna have it up on screen too, just to show you that, and then I guess a recent piece to compare to like a split thing. It was interesting. Also, the fact they were trans. That's like, I wanna say level 7, 8 kind of dating material. Because you usually don't jump into, like, at least in my case again, like, the fandom, and then go, I might be gay! Or, I'm not, but technically dating a trans person isn't gay, because they're, like, in between. Which was a really stupid mentality. And whenever, like, the topic of what they existed as popped up, I didn't really know how to answer it. And at the time, they had a lot of issues with their sexual identity, and I was very immature. That was a doozy, and it made me consider how I went around stuff like that. Because I noticed now that I was really, like, underlyingly disrespectful, and I feel bad. I want to apologize, like, sincerely. I've made huge mistakes in the past. Dating you was probably a mistake to start off with. At least, like, for me, like, starting to be gay. Technically. And I feel bad for putting you through that shit. I don't know. I would rather officially apologize to you like face to face, but I know that's never gonna happen. But I'd rather have it on here so in the case you do actually watch it or whatever, that you actually do see it, and that it gets across. So yeah. I was a shithead. I was a really major shithead. I was like, scruffing my chin. What's up with this whole gay thing? What's it like to be gay? And it sort of, like, opened up the idea of, like, maybe trying to date a dude. And that was, like, my objective at that point, to, like, yeah, I'm gonna date, like, a fully 100% dude and see how it works. Yeah, I dated a guy in Australia. Like, long distance. And we talked over... We talked over Amino. Because I was like, oh, I've never heard of this place called Amino. I was like, what, like, around 9th, 10th grade, I think? And I was like, yeah, this kind of looks like shit. I think it was maybe on a piece that they made that I found, like, on the homepage feed in Furry Amino. And I was like, yo, this looks kind of cool, dude. Because, again, at the time, I was still drawing on my phone, so everything looked good. And then I think it was either me or him that decided to, like, DM me. We talked for a bit, we RP'd. Oh, that's fucking cringy. Oh, God, and then, basically, when we're, like, I was like, we've been talking for 2 weeks. Should we date? I had no patience. Oh god. I had a really bad misconception of how this shit works. Like, wow, this is so fucking easy. I have a boyfriend now. What? He's in Australia? Dude, I fucking love Australia. That went on for like 2 months. And then I was like, I'm just not feeling it anymore. I'm sorry. That was really bad. Oh. I'm just gonna, like, sum up the rest of the relationships. After that, I dated a female, which was odd for me. And at that time, I was like, yeah, I might be bisexual, because I still have this, like, tiny interest in girls compared to, like, wah, men, muscles, bellies, possibly? And then, I guess, like, the whole, like, 90-degree shit that a bunch of them have. We met up at, like, a drama competition. And I think this was in 10th grade? I feel like it was in 10th grade. Because I feel like I can remember being 15-ish at the time. There was 2 drama competitions at this one school, at the same school. After we met up at, like, that drama competition, well, it was sort of like, we were like, she sort of like was like, hey, what's up? And I was like, hi. Like, I was sort of caught off guard a bit. And we started DMing on Instagram. And they somehow, oh, right, I gave them my handle. And we started DMing on that. We planned on, like, having our first official date on, like, the next competition that was, like, 2 to 4 weeks after that one. And we did that. I sat with her in one of the, one of the rows of chairs for, like, the entire time. Like, they were, like, 5'3", I think? Maybe? And at the time, I was like 5'10", 5'11". Still am, sadly. That last inch is fucking killing me. And they're like, their hands, at least compared to mine, like, they were right around, like, right here. I was like, oh my god! How can a human my age have such small hands? They were like a marshmallow, basically. And at the time, well, I guess that's still my preferred female body type. But yeah, that didn't last long. Because after that first date, they got really weird. It sucked me in and sort of convinced me to even, like, have a kid with them at some point. Which is, like, to think of now, like, that's, like, a way of, like, locking in a relationship forever. Because kids are never a good idea. Because I was a kid, and it was torturous for my parents. Still is, I feel like. After that, I dated a dude. That relationship ended, like, a couple months ago. That was really toxic. But I felt like being used was the only way that I could, like, feel a sort of value. And it really fucked me up. Ugh. That was not a fun time. I shared a lot of shit that I regret now. And did a lot of shit that is still haunting me. Great. But it seems whenever I actually did, like, date somebody, was like, I had like this whole like, okay, like in a couple years we're gonna, I'm like, either one of us is gonna move into this state or move in together, or we're gonna like meet up at like an airport or some shit like that, and then it's gonna be like this like slow-mo romantic thing where we're like running to each other, and then like a jump and then impact. Oh my god, I finally get to see you! And stuff like that. To think that like, oh yeah, we'll just date for a couple years and then we'll both just like put a bunch of money together and then I guess go from there. That's always a thing that I can never figure out. It's like, what do you do after you meet up at the airport? Do you just like rent an apartment? I did not plan this out at all. I'm fucked. All I did was just pay for the ticket, and now I'm here and have no idea where I'm at. Both of us don't even know where we're at, probably. So this is a really bad idea. I'm not entirely sure how that would work out. Or that it even, if it would, but if it does, or has, for somebody, like, Pog. Like, the whole heartbreak thing, even though in both cases, I ended the relationship because, one, I got bored, which is understandable, I feel like. And then, two, I just got weirded out and didn't want to be part of it anymore. Feeling like shit for a week. Like, that happened both times. And I noticed no differences in it whatsoever. Even in, like, the recent one that I got out of. No differences. I still felt bad, even though I, again, ended it. Because it just... I didn't like it anymore. I didn't like feeling like the only time that we talked was when he was horny. I've made stupid decisions in the past couple years, and I fully am taking note of them and that they happened, and I'm a better person because of that, because I know not to think of my body being the only way that I can get to somebody. Yeah, I know, it's weird here. In, like, acting like, again, like a two-legged dog, basically. That it opens up the idea of changing something else. Of being something else. Of talking and dating different people, other than, like, who you're told to date when you're born or something like that, or in kindergarten, like, ooh, she looks nice! Yeah. Like, it's just, like, the whole openness thing. And, like, self-discovery. It's probably not gonna make any sense while I'm, like, wrapping all this stuff up, but, like, basically, being a furry sort of opened up the idea of being gay, or bisexual, or, in my current case, queer gender, or not queer gender, queer sexual. I don't know why! I guess queer is more, like, it's like a gray area kind of thing. And bisexual is more like this and this. And I was pan for the time because I was like, yeah, I'm just into people. Like, that's a lie. There's still some like underlining stuff that I'm very aware of while I'm dating somebody. And I just didn't feel like that fit too well. And I feel like I'm just queer sexual now because like the flag colors look, they're like, they look different. And they're not like the whole like, oh, red, like Roy G. Biv spectrum kind of thing. It's like, green, like an olive green, white, and then purple. At some point, I did like green as a kid, and then I like purple and pink and like all of like the more feminine colors nowadays. And also, it just looks really good on a pin. Recently, I got like an opossum pin, which I'm gonna have on screen, from Fursona Pins, and it's like, oh, it just looks so cute, dude, oh my god, look at him, he's got like his little flag and he's curled up in a ball. He's such an ugly trash baby, and that's what I fucking love about it. I also made a new OC that is an opossum, which I will also have on screen. And his name's Greg. That's the end of the video. Probably didn't make much sense. But yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one whenever I decide to, like, come up with another topic or draw something, which I haven't been doing too much. Update! I'm actually enjoying this thing. There's only been one hiccup with it, where, like, it was static for one time. And then I unplugged the USB-C, plugged it back in, it's completely fine. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one whenever I decide to do this again. Thank you, and bye.